hear that manly voice. Establishing an outpost in so remote a location could not have been easy, tenacious devils. My voice isn't really all that manly. I just try to do it a little. I'm trying to do like a little bit different. I know that I'm not a great voice actor, but I try to switch it up just a little bit between characters. What do I think would be more int? Probably int over mind and piety. Yeah. Knights, be not proud. Lord Artorial would rather not linger without cause. The knights have matter here well in hand. Let us return to Falcon's Nest and share our discoveries with Sir Redwald. Come, after tracking heretics across Malm and ice and snow, I would say you are due a few hours' rest next to a warm fire. Yes, please. Can it be with Sir Imeric? I would like that. I want to see Sir Imeric! I've heard him twice mentioned in this story. He's my favorite. I may find him slightly attractive. Is the quest downstairs? Or is it somewhere else? Oh god, there's people. Oh, tamed warbear. That one was unexpected. Apparently there's another quest going on down here. But I do not see the quest. Oops. Who do I have to kill for your heart? Say his name again. Sir Imeric! I love him. Man. Oh, here we go. Oh, I saw Tempered Knight first and I was like, oh god, what's going on? But it's just a hot tempered knight. I can deal with that. An attractive charm. Ooh. I could have 5 clusters, 50 crystals, or 100 shards. I think we'll go with the clusters. The hot-tempered knight is trying to catch his breath. There, I spelled it for you guys. Also, I got some Skype messages that I gotta read quickly. After playing Witcher 3, I get to put new heat sinks in my motherboard. Okay, I'm not gonna respond to that. Too busy streaming with you guys. Yeah, I'm Eric. Alright. Gods be cursed! Mere moments ago I was mobbed by this huge swarm of frost grenades. I made away with my life but dropped my magic talisman in the confusion. It was a gift from my family, but the instant those monsters saw it, they lost all interest in me. They tore the thing apart and fled with the pieces. That talisman carries a lot of sentimental value for me. I have to get it back, but I can't leave my post. You strike me as quite the capable sort. Be a good lass and recover it for me, would you? Did that sound hot-tempered enough? I don't know, I feel like his text just doesn't work with his name. It looked like a good talisman was broken into 3 separate pieces. I didn't see which of the beasts nabbed the pieces, mind you. I was more concerned with escaping before they regained their interest in me. But please, slay the frost grenades and recover the talisman for me. Can do. Alright, needs more Minxy. Well, I'm gonna need to buy more, That's what I should have done when I was in Bent Branch! God damn it. Are you less upset because it's now that you know who it is? Sorry, Merrick. Oh my goodness! I keep wanting to do a finishing move. Alright, there's another one over here. If somebody's killing it, it's gonna basically be dead by the time I get there. I think there's more. Yeah, there's more back here. Also being killed. Handy. Oh god, so much. So much killing going on back here. Oh, there's one. There's somebody after it already. Alright, let's see if we can get in on this. Here, I'll be a jerk. Shoot it this way so I can get a couple more hits on it before they get turned around. Where are they? Oh, that first one I killed didn't drop it, so I might have to kill more. Damn it. Damn it. They're all around here, but they're just not spawned. Alright, let's check on Minxy. Oh, getting there. That's still actually a lot of XP that I need. I don't think I'm gonna level before I finish this. Frost grenade! Must kill! Gonna shoot it behind you! Turn around! Oh, I missed out on another one. Oh, there's one this way. Oh, somebody is killing it already. Let me in on the action. There. Did I get credit? Yes! Success. Alright. Let's go back to the hot tempered knight. Gorgagne Holding? Gorgagne Mills? Gorgony? I don't know how you pronounce that. I shall just make shit up. He's a noob. You can take him with your level 50 bard. Have you the pieces of my magic talisman? I guess hot tempered doesn't necessarily translate to angry, but... Oh, you found them! Words cannot fully express my gratitude! My family made the talisman from an ice crystal. It was meant to protect me, but to be honest, there's more than enough cold around here without me carrying this thing. Still, it carries no small amount of sentimental value for me. I wonder what made the frost grenades swarm over it so. Do they plan to eat it? For something that was supposed to protect me, this talisman is doing a dreadful job. Whatever the reason, I'd much prefer not to get attacked again. I'd be soon to put this somewhere safe in the barracks rather than carrying it on my person. Thank you again for recovering it for me. You don't like Ishgard's layout. What's wrong with it? Oh, I get all of them! Alright, I thought I had to choose. I'll take it. Do I have to go back to... No, there's something on the way. I guess I'll run back. Whoops. Too layered. Yeah, oh, I see what you mean. Yeah. I don't mind it, but yeah, it's kind of confusing. It's a little bit confusing. Oh my goodness, jump over this fence. I bet I need to be this way, because I'm not going to be able to jump up that cliff face. Upland Mylodon. Don't aggro me! Oh, it totally did. Oh well, let me just run away from you. Tis nothing. Nothing, I say. Is this a frozen path, or is it a river? A little both? Oh, the bridge. How handy. I shall cross it. I kind of wish I'd finished my ARR quests before now, because they're kind of annoying me to just see them on my list all the time. It sounded like Shiva singing for a second. Pigajigga! I'm amused at looking at people's names. Whoops, Steinbach. Ooh, what's this up here? That looks pretty cool. Somehow I suspect I can't jump up that. No. You wish you'd finished your Hildebrand? You haven't finished Hildebrand? Did you at least pay attention to Hildebrand? Because a set of quests I didn't love, because I was just like, I have no idea who these people are, why I should care, or what's going on. But then it got better, and then it was okay. Alright, I know I can get up here because I did it last time. It just involves jumping here-ish, yeah, and then going this way. There we go. Shilly Shally! What a name. Oh, Kagu's here. You've already slain those horrid wolves? You have my deepest thanks. There was a time when there were Ishgardian troops stationed at Camp Riversmeet. Should we recover the camp, we were able to station soldiers there again. It would make our patrols safer, let them cover more area. Before long, we shall move to reclaim the camp. When that time comes, I may call upon your services again. Cool. Done and done. Oh, that's Kay too. Banana Juice Hades. That's quite the name. I'm assuming that was someone named Banana Juice on the Hades server, and that's why they have that name. Because otherwise, I just don't understand why you would ever name yourself Banana Juice Hades. Oh, you know what? I'm gonna do this. Where? Why is this stuff running around like crazy people? Oh shoot. Well, I'm gonna kill this mess and then I'm gonna move on. I don't wanna stick around till this one's done. All the holy guys, all the holy. I love it. Alright. Let me run away. I don't think I'm leaving this zone anytime soon, so I should still get credit for it. Postcards? Oh, this music. I see the Aetherite! Oh man, that's a really tall tower. I didn't realize that went up that high. Maybe you paid attention to the storyline? Of Hildebrand? Is that where you're- Oh, the leg! Is that where you're maybeing? The leg is real! Oh my goodness! Oh my goodness. Oh, 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 oh! Quest this way. Did you find them? Did you find my grandmother's things? Tis, tis, Crejo. Well, you just need to watch my stream while I do the storyline, and then you'll get to experience it along with me. You found them already? Thank you ever so much. These are my grandfather's trappings from his time as a ferryman on the river. Of course, that was a long time ago. The river's frozen over now. There's no need for a ferryman when you can simply walk across. Now, however, my grandmother lies bedridden in Ishgard. My hope is that if I show him these mementos of the past, he might remember his youth and recover his strength. Alright. You say so. It's way more exciting this way anyways, yeah. Oh my goodness, the leg though. Ugh. Ugh. Alright, manly voice time. Double manly voice. Lord Arturiel, Mistress Ivana, full glad I am to see you both hale and healthy. What news? I'm so animated. You mean to say you hunted down the heretics on your own and slew them before reinforcements could arrive? By the fury! I believe we've made great strides towards purging these lands of the heretics, and I mean to say as much when I deliver my report to my father in the Holy See. I can't do two different voices. This is just ridiculous. As will I, Lord Altoriel. May it serve to remind our superiors that what houses Durandere and Fortomps could achieve through continued cooperation. Indeed, I trust you and your knights are content to handle the rest. We most certainly are, my lord. During your short time with us, you and Mistress Ivana have accomplished far more than I had thought possible. I cannot in good conscience impose upon you any longer. Pray, return to Ishgard with my thanks. As you wish, Sir Redwall. We thank you for your hospitality. More quests. Oh, no, I got credit for that gold, for that fate. Excellent. Glad I didn't stick around. Alright. Now I need to go back to Fortomps. Alright, let's do that the quick way. I wonder how far I'll get before I run out of story of appropriate level. Ugh, so much lag. I want to go to the last vigil. The Holy See of Ishgard! The pillars. Alright. I helped both brothers. Now what's gonna happen? Artorial! Mistress Ivana, I would speak plain. From the first, I questioned your motives and your competence. Unjustly, I now realize. Rumors have a way of growing more fantastic as they are spread, and quite frankly, those surrounding you beggar belief. But Harshafan swore that all the stories were true. He championed your cause and begged Father to grant you patronage. And he duly listened, because for all his wisdom, he has never been able to say no to my dear half-brother. The legacy of my father's sole indiscretion. Wait. Who's his half-brother? Harshafar? Mother hated him, of course. Even on her deathbed, she refused to acknowledge him, and to be honest, she was not alone in her feelings. But that is not the worst of it. At Camp River's Meet, when we came upon the wounded knight, I knew immediately that one of us would have to pursue the heretics alone, an onerous task fraught with danger. And there you were, the savior of Eorzea and honored guest of House Fortomps, my new comrade in arms, Harshafan's dear friend. And I told myself it was to be a test, but part of me hoped you would fail. Yet you accepted the task without a word of protest, nor any sign of fear. And you duly tracked the enemy down, faced him alone, and lived to tell the tale. Actually, the enemy was female, but thanks. Well, I guess there were some males in there. Plainly, Harshafan had it right all along. That I doubted your strength bespeaks my own weakness. But I will not doubt you again, Mistress Ivana. On that you have my word. Good, Artorial. You're much less annoying than your brother, I'll give you that. But he's just a kid. A really frickin' annoying kid. But a kid nonetheless. Alright. The House of Fortomps Steward. I'm not in a quest yet. Divine Intervention. He looks as if he has something to say. Ooh. Oh man, I'm gonna get my flying chocobo. Ah, yeah. Oh man, he's so annoying. He's so annoying. He kept calling me old girl. I wanted to like punch him in the face. Ah, Mr. Sabana, my lord, the Count, much desires to speak with you regarding your time with Lord Altorio and Lord Amenelaine. If you would remain here for a moment. I really like these green chairs. I want some for my house. I hope we get lots of cool new furniture for Ishgard, or for Heavensward. Oh, what's his face?
The hero returns.
Edmund.
I cannot thank you enough for saving young Emanelane's life. Aye, he told me everything. I've also received letters from both House Zamael and Durandere.
Zamael!
Conduct.
That's how you pronounce
it. And that of House Fortomp. You've won us much honor, my friend.
My lord.
I already forgot how to pronounce it.
Speak. Pray forgive the intrusion, my lord, but I bring grave tidings. Master Alfano and Mistress Tataru have been detained on suspicion of fomenting heresy.
Oh dear. That's not good.
What? Explain.
They were observed entering a tavern in the lower levels on some half dozen occasions. There, it is claimed, they made a number of inquiries. Inquiries which brought them into contact with certain elements. Twas this which prompted a Knight of the Heaven's War to demand that they be questioned. Sir Grinno, my lord.
Oh, it is. There is a Heaven's Ward.
Sir Grinno is a brute. An exceedingly accomplished brute, but a brute nonetheless. Alas, he is also a son of House Zamayo.
Zamayo. I'm going to remember how to pronounce this properly. Zamayo. I'm going to forget this. Zamayo. So you forget the D, and it's Ma-L. Okay. Zamayo. I can do that. I can remember that. Smile. Sounds like smile.
How quickly we forget the petty nature of men. I'd wager your friends are no more than pawns in another of my countrymen's games. Such is the way of things between the high houses.
Dun dun dun! Hi, Insane NK! Morning! It's only 10, it's just after 10 here. You must be, in Europe somewhere. Possibly, if it's morning already. Or further than that, I don't even know. Oh, back to my voice acting. Though you've won the hearts and minds of many of my countrymen, there are those who will never be swayed. Men who will dismiss your efforts and resent your successes, even as we celebrate them. 'Tis like that one such member of House Zamael, I got it, is manipulating Sir Grinno, for he's not a man to dabble in politics of his own volition. He may genuinely believe your friends to be guilty, though I'm quite certain his masters know better. Yet the truth will avail us not if we cannot prove their innocence. You would do well to speak to Sarai Merrick at the congregation of our knights most heavenly. He will know more of these charges. Yes! I get to go see Sarai Merrick! Woohoo! So excited. I was missing him. I wanted to go hang out with him. Now I get to speak to Sarai Merrick in Foundation. Aw, yeah. Final Fantasy VII Remake hype? You know what? In theory, I'm super hyped about it, but I wasn't super hyped by their video. And I don't really like how the characters look when they make them into, like, more realistic characters. I don't know, I feel like it's just not the same. Where the heck is Sarai Merrick? Am I not in Foundation? No. Oh yeah, okay. I just had to zoom in more to see where the heck I needed to go. So he is... Okay, I need to go to the Forgotten Knight. Excuse me. Oh, Creejo. Don't hate on Imeric. Alright, it's... Oh, the lag. I hate these city zones that kill me. I'm Merrick! Yay! Man. Oh. I love his armor and his hair and his eyes. He's so hot. He is a little bit girly though, I guess. I don't know. I like him still. It has been too long, Ari. Would that this visit came under happier circumstances. You are come to plead for Master Elfinode and Mistress Tataru, I take it. Poor Creejo. Word of their detainment reached us while I was delivering my report on the Venu Primal. Truly, I do not know which is more ludicrous, these charges or that flying feathered whale. That Sir Grimaud's accusations are baseless, I have no doubt. Refuting them will be difficult, however, as he is a knight of the Heaven's Ward. I speak of the personal guard of the Archbishop, the 12 finest knights in all of Ishgard sworn to serve his eminence alone. Where'd the music go? Suffice it to say, their testimony is unimpeachable, and I have not the authority to challenge their actions. After all the Scions have done, routing out the heretics and defeating Shiva, helping us defend the steps of fate and drive back the Dravenian horde, after proving themselves true allies on countless occasions, is there naught we can do? I fear there is but one path left to us. We must demand a trial by combat. Oh, am I gonna get fight something? Am I gonna fight something? But of course! In a trial by combat sanctioned by the Inquisition, the victor's claim is judged true regardless of the petitioner's standing. Under Ishgardian, trial by combat makes absolutely no sense. Like, it makes no sense at all, but whatever, we'll go with it. Under Ishgardian law, a trial by combat pits the accuser against the accused. In this instant, Master Alphanode and Mr. Tataru will be expected to face Sir Grinot and a second of his choosing. Another knight of the Heaven's Ward, most like. How are they gonna beat him? Two of them? By the Fury! That can hardly be considered fair! Master Alphanode's magical talents will not have gone unnoticed, meaning that he will have no choice but to participate. Mr. Tataru, on the other hand, is quite obviously bereft of martial skill, and should be afforded the right to name a champion to fight in her stead. Yes! I'm gonna be her champion! I'm gonna kick some ass! Lest you doubt, I am ready and willing to serve in this capacity— No, Imeric! I'm gonna fight! As I'm sure is Lord Harshafont. But all present know that you are the most accomplished warrior among us, and mayhaps the realm at large. Damn straight I am! I'm gonna kick some ass! With all my healing glory. Then it's settled! I will visit Master Alphanode at once and inform him of our intentions, Ari. Meet me at the tribunal when you've made ready. Until then, my friend. Super excited, guys. Let him fight so you can help the other side. Negatory. Negatory. Man, there we go. Aw, look at him. He's just so tall. I love that. I like come up to his waist. Oh my goodness, it's Kagu! And Kay! Alright, where am I going? Where's the tribunal? The pillars? Where? It is... Oh, I can tell... I can, Nox agrees with me. I wrote Heart Imeric in Linkshell chat, and she's like, haha, right? So not just me. Not just me. I'm sorry, Krito. Harshafont! Listen carefully, Ari. When the trial begins, the petitioner will be asked to restate his charges, and the accused invited to respond. Then, in accordance with the law, they will be asked to restate their request for a trial by combat. Once the High Adjudicator acknowledges Mistress Tataru's right to name a champion, that is when you must make your entrance. Oh, I cannot wait to see the look on Sir Grinot's face when he sees his true opponent. 'Twill be priceless. Sorry, Krujo. I'm sorry. More seriously, should you begin to lose heart, look to me in the stands and I shall cheer so loud you will wonder how you could ever have contrived to doubt yourself. Now are you ready? Harshafont is just so, I don't even know. He's just so, so into this. Oh man, that looks awesome. There's gonna be voice acting here, I'm pretty sure. Let's crank her up. So much anger.
We are gathered here today under the watchful gaze of the Fury to ascertain the guilt of two souls in a trial by combat. Petitioners, step forward.
Oh man, oh, I love those guys' armor. Damn, I want me some of that.
Sir Grinot, for the benefit of all here present, I would ask you to repeat the charges which you have leveled against this man and this woman.
Oh yeah, I have to click buttons.
I, Sir Grinot de Zemile, brother of the Heaven's Ward,
did bear witness to these two foreigners consorting with heretics.
Blah, blah, blah.
Let the accused step forward. Alfino Leveyer, Tataru Taru, you have heard the charges leveled against you. Will you take up arms to refute Sir Grinno's claim and thereby prove your innocence in the eyes of gods and men?
I, Alfino Leveyer, am innocent of this charge and claim my right to trial by combat.
I, Tataru Taru, am innocent of this charge. But I am no warrior and cannot fight. So, I claim the right to name a champion.
And it's me!
To the old and the infirm, the young and the weak, this right we allow. Very well. Who will stand for this woman?
Me! Ha ha! My grand entrance. Oh yeah! Look at me, all badass.
Just as I was beginning to doubt the efficacy of the Asgardian justice system. Come, my friend, let us put an end to this mama's.
Oh, he's so happy to see me. Oh dear! If you lose, the floor just falls out from under you? That's terrifying. Oh yeah.
Ohalone, render unto us your judgment. Raise up the righteous and cast down the wicked.
Let's make sure I've got a. Ooh, I like that weapon. That's like the other weapon though. Oh, let me turn this down so I can hear myself think. Holy crap! Oh shoot! Tell me I don't have to watch that again. Oh no, really? Why? Why did they glitch you that like that? Ugh. All right, let's just skip this cutscene. As awesome as it was, let's just make with the fighting. Oh, is Kay getting in on the Imeric love? She is. Alright. You know what? Need some holy, guys. Need some holy. How you like that? Oh yeah, okay, let's not holy them. Oh, he can't be knocked back. You have your pride, Alphanode? What's your pride gonna do for you? Oh man! Why is my health going down faster than theirs? This isn't cool. I mean, I am a healer, so it's not that big of a deal. Oh, I probably should have cast Protect. Let's do that now. Hey, who healed me? Oh no! I will save you, Alphanode. Good god, steel chain? My thanks. You're welcome, Alphanode. No, don't stand in the bad. Oh, why you gotta stand in the bad, silly? You've been indulged enough, heathen swine. I don't think we have. You're gonna die.
I've got you now.
You've got me now, huh? Thunder thrust. Let's know. Ow! Okay. Oh god. Oh man, come on! I beat Bahamut! Your silly mechanics are nothing to me! You foolish man! Oh, Alphanode, why do you take so long to kill people? Why are you so weak, Sus? Oh, he's in the chain again. Whatever, I'm gonna kill this guy first. Then I'll break out Alpha Node. Then I'll heal him up. And then Grinnow the Bull shall feel the wrath of my healing magic. Alright, Alpha Node, you need some heals. Here. Whoops, let's not stand in that. Alright, let's divine seal this. Alpha Node, you have just too much health. Too much health. It's disgusting. Should Benny you and see how much health you really have. Alright, a little bit more healing. Let's throw some, Alright, Sir Grinnow, this is the end for you. How dare you accuse my friends of heresy, however you pronounce words. Alright. Oh, why did he keep throwing? I guess it's a good thing I wasn't fighting him, that would have been unfortunate. Oh, Tataru's standing there. What else do we got? Do you see anybody else? No, there's just people. We know who they are. Oh, we can see these guys. There was four guys there. Where'd the other ones go? Are they down here watching us? Oh, I'm tired of breaking you out, Alpha Node. I'm just gonna leave you in there. It's not like you get out of the way of AoEs anyways, or doing much to help me kill this dude, so... You just stay there, right? Done and done. Ahri is OP, indeed. Don't mess with the Warrior of Light. Aw, weak sauce. Weak sauce, dudes. Oh, my nose is all runny. We won! Aw. Uh-oh. The Fury has spoken. Alpha Node, Levier, Tataru Taru, you are hereby acquitted of all charges. Blessed are we who receive her wisdom and see justice wrought by her divine hand. Petitioners accused, go forth in peace. Aw, yeah. Delivered from an untimely demise yet again, my thanks as always. No problem. No problem, Alphano. I got your back. Harshifant. By the Fury, what a splendid victory! To see how you strove in the face of adversity. Two brave young souls bound together by a puissant? Bonds of camaraderie. Why, it stirred me to the very depths of my soul. You know what? I feel like I have a fairly good vocabulary, but this game pushes the limits of my vocabulary. Having been treated to such a rousing spectacle, it seemed only right that I present you with this humble token of my admiration. Thanks, dude. With it, you may summon a black chocobo, fully trained and ready to fly. Oh, it's beautiful. It's so beautiful. Magnificent, is she not? Strong yet sleek, elegant yet eager. What say you, Ahri? Will you take her for your steed? Oh, will I ever? Oh, who's this dude? Lord Harshifant, chocobos are prohibited in the supreme sacred tribunal of Halonic inquisitory doctrine. Your steed must remain outside. Man, that was a mouthful. Oh, kick him! Kick him in the face! No? Alright. That would have been more fun. We're just like, eh? Oh well. Complete! Alright, I'm gonna get a... Aether currents now accessible. You have obtained a black chocobo. When riding this mount, you will have the ability to fly, provided certain conditions have been met. To fly in a given region, you must first find and attune to all the local aether currents. In order to attune to some aether currents, you will need to complete certain quests. However, most can be discovered via exploration. Excuse me. To aid you in this endeavor, you've also obtained an aether compass, which will provide you with both the bearing and the distance to the nearest aether current upon use. Should you lose the compass, you may speak with Gibralant at the Forgotten Knight to obtain another. To review your progress, select travel from the menu, followed by aether currents. Hi, kitten. Oh. Disclosure! Lord Harshapont thinks you could do with a well-deserved rest. Black chocobos are all well and good, but the true reward for your efforts is exoneration of your comrades, indeed. They shall be released upon the completion of certain minor formalities, which I mean to see to personally. In the meantime, pray return to Fort Thompson Manor. The Count has done so already and will doubtless be eager to discuss the day's events. Alright. Now, right, I know what that quest is. That's the dark, Dragons of Eorzea. I had to look at this guy because Daystar is the name of a character in a book. I guess it's not a. There's four in the series, so it's like a quadrilogy about dragons. So I was curious as to if his FC was named in relation to it, but it was not. Welcome, Mistress of- Oh, why do I keep reading out this thing? He says the same thing every time. Helone smiles on us yet again, Mr. Savannah, guiding you to victory and setting your comrades free. Oh, come on, I had nothing to do with Helone, just because I'm friggin' badass. I confess, I did fear for your safety, which is not to say I doubted your prowess, you understand. I merely knew the strength of your opponents. Ahem, you do have the habit of exceeding my expectations. Besting two of the Heaven's Ward while the city elite looked on? By the fury, anyone who hasn't been paying attention to you will surely do so from now on. Aerie the badass indeed. Who's knocking on the door? My lord. I wasn't very good at voice acting. We have just received a message from the vault. His Eminence, the Archbishop, requests the presence of Mr. Savannah. Damn straight he does. An invitation from the Archbishop? What an honor. A personal summons is indeed a great honor, and given recent events, you would be wise not to delay. Go, Mr. Savannah. We shall speak anon. A priest will be waiting for you outside the vault. Identify yourself to him and he will escort you inside. Where the heck's the vault? Man! God, I want to like move into their house. I love their furniture. Damn. Oh, this fireplace. So much want. Alright, where the heck is the vault? Up there? Okay. Ah! Is there a closer? No, let's just run there. Ah, Kagu beat me here. We are honored to receive you, Mistress Savannah. This way, please. So much creaking. Ooh, Sir Imeric.
Your Eminence, it is my honor to present to you the Warrior of Light.
I have heard the tales of your many grand endeavors. The Lord Commander has also been most effusive in his praise. I am Thordon the Seventh, Archbishop of the Ishgardian Orthodox Church, and I bade you come here that I might offer my personal apologies. You will forgive me for not calling upon you as courtesy would dictate, but as you can see, my more sprightly days are long behind me. But I digress. Your companions were wrongly accused of heresy and subjected to gross indignities. This, I am sorry to say, was the result of negligence on the part of our nation's protectors. Negligence born of an excess of zeal. Is that not so, Sir Zephyrin?
Yes, Your Eminence. Regrettably, it would appear that we of the Heaven's Ward were in receipt of erroneous information. Sir Grinno has ever been headstrong. He pressed charges before the truth had been ascertained, for which I most sincerely apologize.
God, I want their armor. Not his armor.
An unfortunate misunderstanding born of an earnest desire to serve Ishgard, but one which should never have occurred. For who could doubt the character of those who bested Shiva and drove the Horde from the steps of faith? Not I. That much is certain. That will be all, Sir Zephyrin. I would speak with our guest in private.
Your Eminence? I...
Do you not trust me?
As you wish, Your Eminence. That will be all for today.
Bye, Imeric. Oh, look at that look I just gave him.
Privacy is a luxury rarely afforded one in my position. Now tell me, young lady, what do you know of the Asians?
Hmm. Talking about Asians now.
Much and more, I shouldn't wonder. Being the bringer of light. You should know that I myself have met with them. Have entertained them as guests, even.
Oh, that's terrifying.
Those harbingers of chaos and strife offered us power that we might continue our war against the dragons. I have no intention of aiding their cause, of course, nor less of being their puppet. Yet, were I to refuse them outright, I should learn naught of their true objectives and remain powerless to stop them. Thus have I hearkened to their words with interest and paid lip service to their beliefs, biding my time and preparing for the inevitable conflict.
Should we trust him? Do we believe
him? And why do I tell you this? Because there is naught in this world they fear more than the power of the Warrior of Light.
Damn straight they fear me.
If we are to rid ourselves of these vile interlopers, we must need work together. With our combined strength, I have faith that we can wrest Eorzea from their grasp and pave the way for a lasting peace. Think on it.
I really hate the phrase must needs. Drives me nuts. What do I do now? Oh, I go back to Fort Thompson Manor. Oh, the leg. Sid Rabanaster. That's interesting. Oh, somebody would have done what I did. Oh, it's Nadia. Oh wait, apparently that works for them. Apparently they're allowed to go in whenever the heck they want. Nah, I still have to speak to this guard. Why, hello there, Alphanon.
There you are. I confess, I was more than a little concerned when I learned that you had been summoned to the vault. What did they want with you? Well, well. A formal apology and an admonishment of those responsible. I see my fears were wholly misplaced. By the gods! The Archbishop freely admits to consorting with Asians. So, their ambitions extend to Ishgard as well.
Oops.
We will have new primals to contend with erelong, of that you may be certain. Tis but a matter of time. Yet shorn of the support of our missing allies, what can we realistically hope to achieve?
In the midst of all the excitement, I completely forgot to tell you.
Uh-oh.
When I was asking around about the Scions, I heard the most awful rumor. General Rauburn is to be executed for crimes against the Sultanate!
If the Flame General dies, we will lose a staunch ally, and the one man capable of holding the Sultana's assassins to account. Lord Orshifon was wise to counsel restraint, but this business will brook no delay.
I mean, were we really surprised that he's being sentenced to death? Like, I don't get it. Is that a surprise to us?
We cannot permit this execution to take place. We must save Rauburn.
Like, everybody thinks he killed the Sultanate. Of course he's going to be sentenced to death. I mean, it's wrong, of course, but it's really not surprising. lucky number 7. What? Complete the quest disclosure. Interesting. I don't understand what lucky number 7 has to do with it. I'm gonna turn this down. Ooh, more X. Ooh, level 51 quest. Damn, I'm almost 52. Alphanode wishes to share his plan of action for rescuing Rabon. Though the situation calls for urgency, it would avail us little to charge headlong into Ulda without a plan. Before we can formulate a plan, however, we must first learn how things stand in the Sultanate, which is why I propose that we visit Limsa Lominsa. Ah, you heard me right. While you were about your altruistic endeavors, I acted as intermediary in trade negotiations between House Fortomps and a Lominsian consortium. During said negotiations, an opportunity to send word to the Admiral presented itself, and I duly seized it. I am happy to report that we have a stout ally in Limsa. The Admiral has pledged her full cooperation in any effort to rescue Rabon. Accordingly, I have agreed to meet with her, that we may discuss how best to proceed. Naturally, I told her to expect us both. Your presence never fails to embolden our allies, after all. When you arrive in Limsa Lominsa, make yourself known to Sergeant Xanthale at Bulwark Hall on the lower decks. He will admit you to the bridge. Hello, Arthas! He just, like, chucked himself at the back of my chair. Alright, I guess we're going to Limsa. May it be less laggy than Ishgard. Oh, Arthas. Why are you so noisy? Oh, it's Alphanode. The Admiral's been expecting you. Say the word and I will take you to her. The word. Apparently she has a new voice actor. Let's see it.
Friends, it is good to see you safe and well.
Oh yeah, that's really different.
I had not counted on you seeking, let alone finding refuge within the Holy See. But full glad was I to learn that you had.
Thankfully, we had allies there who took us under their wing. And theirs was not the only aid we receive, I suspect. When we fled Uldar, we fully expected to become wanted men. Known to all and hounded at every turn. Yet that did not come to pass. On the contrary, 'twould seem the charges against us have not been made public. Might we have you to thank for that, Admiral?
Sharp as ever, Master Alphanode. On Marshal Tarrapin's urging, the Elder Seedseer and I demanded that the Syndicate suppress news of the Scion's alleged crimes until such time as irrefutable evidence could be found. Our argument was simple. Lacking proof, to accuse the saviors of the realm of so unlikely a crime would have the people up in arms. In their wisdom, the Syndicate agreed, as you yourself have seen. There is something you should know. Some few days prior to the banquet, the Elder Seedseer and I were summoned for a private audience with the Sultana. There, she revealed her intent to announce her abdication, that she might pave the way for the establishment of an Uldan Republic.
What? But such an announcement would have plunged the entire nation into chaos.
She was well aware of that. 'Twas for fear of what might ensue that she summoned us. Her Grace wanted the Elder Seedseer and I to lend Rauban a helping hand, you see? To aid him in preserving the peace during the transition.
So, having somehow caught wind of her plan, Lolorito and Taleji plotted the Sultana's assassination in the hope of maintaining the constitutional status quo. But they must have known that her death would sow as much chaos as her abdication. Chaos from which Taleji alone might feasibly stand to profit. Surely Lolorito would never knowingly... Ah... Could it be? I dare not hope.
The Uldan authorities have yet to announce the Sultana's passing.
Really? It feels like it's been forever since that happened.
To allay any suspicion that may arise from Her Grace's absence, they have issued a statement to the effect that she is presently convalescing from illness.
Mayhap they're waiting for a fitting moment to break the news, or mayhap they know of some other reason to delay.
Something else has been bothering me, Admiral. I was dismayed to learn that General Raoban is to be executed. Yet upon hearing the news, I could not help but wonder why he had been kept alive for so long.
That's what I was wondering! Glad Elfinode's thinking the same thing.
Pray mistake not my meaning. I am, of course, overjoyed that our friend still draws breath, and that he might yet be saved. But if his enemies truly wished to eliminate him, they could have done so immediately. I see no reason for this delay.
Aye, you've struck upon an important point, Master Alphino. Following his capture, Raoban had been held in the Marasarja pit within Uldar. In recent days, however, he has reportedly been moved to an unknown location. Queerly, 'twas not the brass blades who spirited him away either, but a band of soldiers decked in blue.
The Crystal Braves.
Oh man, damn Crystal Braves.
Aye. If I read the winds aright, the arrangement between Lord Lolorito and the Braves has come under strain. At any rate, if we're to rescue Raoban, we'll have to find him first. And you'll be glad to hear that I have already entrusted the task to those best able to see it done. Our friends of Doma.
Excuse me. Raoban's survival is vital to the Eorzean Alliance. We can ill afford to lose him. But I cannot send troops into Uldah. 'Twould spell the end of the Alliance, and war like as not. If there is to be a rescue, it falls to you and yours to attempt it. Can do. I would not have it any other way, Admiral. It was I who founded the Crystal Braves, and I who must take responsibility for their actions. Spoken like a true leader, Master Alphinode. By way of a first step, you should seek out our Doman contact. You will find her among the frontier hands at Revenant's Toll, working in a kitchen. Interesting. Guess I'm off to Mordona. To Mordona! Whoops, let's do... Has Mordona expanded with Heaven's Word? Or not? I don't remember seeing any announcement to that effect. Oh, the leg. The leg. Oh god. Oh god, the leg. Oh man, those beds. How would you like to sleep on a plank of wood with a little sheet over top of you? It seems uncomfortable. I'm curious as to if they added any new housing in here. No. Of course not. That would be too easy. Wait, who am I talking to in here? Oh god, the leg. The leg! Oh, do I have to go upstairs or something? I can do that. Is this a door? No, it doesn't go anywhere. I don't think I've ever been in this room. Higiri! Mistress Ari, I knew in my heart you were safe, but to see you again in the flesh, words cannot express my relief. Even as the victory feast was taking place, the Crystal Braves turned upon us and took the Rising Stones, my force. Amid the chaos, some few of my compatriots were able to slip away unnoticed. Since then, we have remained in Revenant's Toll, keeping watch over the mutineers while awaiting your return. You've done well by us, and we Domans do not soon forget our debts. We swear to do all within our power to aid you. Alright. Dun dun dun! Haha, no expansion? What? What are you saying? Are you saying you don't have the expansion? Did I ask you something about that? I'm confused. Higiri is eager to assist me. Of course she is. Shortly before you arrived, I received word from Limsa Luminsa that you were searching for General Rauban. As Admiral would have informed you, he was recently moved from his cell in the Marisaja pit. At the same juncture, Yuhas and the 3rd unit were observed leaving the Rising Stone. This can be no simple coincidence. Their purpose, we believe, is to escort the Flame General to the scene of his execution. Oh, doesn't have an expansion. Okay, in Mordona. Alright, fair enough. Thank you. Suffice to say, we have people shadowing the 3rd. If you would join the hunt, pray seek out Dewera. Which is Drybone, isn't it? Yeah. Hello. My glass of wine is done. I'm gonna go fill up another glass. I'll be right back. I will still talk. Alright, this is wine and not me peeing, if you can hear it. I don't know if you can hear it. Probably. Well, I don't know if I should drink this wine, but I shall! I shall not sleep until I do. Alright, I am back. You know what I haven't seen? I haven't seen, although I don't look very closely at people's characters, but I haven't seen any Aura running around. Possibly because I don't look at people. But I haven't seen anyone noticeably Aura. Person is hiding back here. Oh, Alphanode. And Higiri changed her clothes. How fancy. I have been expecting you. Time is of the essence, so I shall be direct. Whoops, missed one. Yuhas and his men are bound for Halatali. We believe that is where they intend to carry out the execution. That would make sense. Hosen is presently keeping watch over the entrance. Let us make haste and join him. Why do I have to come all the way out here if I need to go to Halatali? Seriously? You guys are just not efficient enough. We could have went in Drybone and saved me a run. Then we could have gone straight from Drybone out here. Why do I have to go to Highbridge? I don't even understand. So much silliness. Oh god, that's a big hole. Are the new... What is it? Sightseeing logs? Where's sightseeing log? Are the new ones accessible? No. I guess... Oh, I think there's a quest you have to do that opens it? Probably. There's always quests for stuff like that. Tuco! I want to save Raoban. Too bad I can't save his arm. But honestly, his speech. I'm from Ulda because when you have to like travel to all the cities and listen to their leader's speeches, it was Raoban's speech that I liked the best. You can have some wine, creature. I wish I could give you wine. I have tons of it. I have a whole box that I've barely started. But I will not be finishing tonight because I would die. Where am I going here? Oh, apparently I went to the wrong side. It's Pyramid Head! You've come at a good time, my friends. But moments ago, the traitor Ilbird arrived and entered Halatali. Oh, this guy's doing the trick where his thing glows even when it's on his back. From this, we may be certain that General Raoban is being held within. Excellent. Give me my XP. Oh my goodness, what is this? Still 115? Shit. God. Gah. Raoban, Hozan would brief you on the mission to rescue Raoban. There's no time to lose. General Alden may be executed at any moment. You must enter Halatali and free him from his captors. Actually, that might be an upgrade, I think, because unless my ring's probably 120, so I don't think it's an upgrade. Please see to your preparations and tell me when you are ready to proceed. One of our own will accompany you inside. I'm ready. I'm ready. Swing by and we can share the bottle. Yeah, I'll just, after I've been drinking, yes, let me drive, like, 9 hours to, oh, you'll swing by. Okay, no, that's fair. I thought you said I should swing by. But yeah. You can swing by here. Oh, man, that upskirt shot.
Pray, forgive me, my
Hikari. Oh. She's talking. Gotta crank up the volume.
Lady Yugiri! Master Alphanor. I am pleased to see that the light of resolve shines in your eyes once more.
Ah, yes. How pathetic I must have seemed to you when we last met. I am ashamed to recall it. For a time, I was well and truly lost. But with the aid of my comrades, I have since refound my purpose, and I shall take care not to misplace it again.
Since your escape from Ulda, my fellow shinobi and I have shadowed the Crystal Braves every step. In hopes of learning the Scion's whereabouts. Regrettably, our investigation has yet to yield any useful information. Pray, forgive us.
Never! Find me some information about them. They cannot be dead.
You need not apologize, my lady. We are grateful for all that you have done on our behalf. Besides, Raoban is no less a friend, and we cannot well abandon him to his fate.
Hozan! The three of us shall attend to the Flame General's rescue. Pray, draw away the guards by the entrance. Take Doware and Higiri with you.
Doware? That's its name. Oh, that upskirt. Look at it, guys. Check it out. I know you love it.
With me!
Volume down. Hello, Halatali. What's up this way? Not a soul from the Colosseum to be seen. This bodes ill. Oh, that's an exit. Alright. Take the lead, Master Ari. Alright, they're not calling me Mistress Ari anymore. I guess I'm Mistress Ivana and Master Ari. I shall follow close upon you. Alright. All this music. Crystal Brave Lancer, you deserve to die. You must die. All the dying. You die now. You die now. Oh god, you don't die fast enough. This is gonna be a long fight.
Thank you.
Oh, I can't even put them underneath these things. They're all brokey. Oh, I should probably take out the white mage first. Probably a good idea, huh? Oh, no knockback.
Leave this to me.
Really? Okay. She's serious? I feel like I'm supposed to help her kill. Yugiri Mistwalker. Sounds like she should be a panda monk from WoW. Let's take the quick way down. Following me? They took him the long way around. It's Raoban! I found him! Oh, they did take the quick way down, good. The General! But where are his captors? I mislike the look of this. Yeah, probably. General! You came! Of course, Raoban. I can't do a good Raoban voice. Oh, Raoban! He is bound by some manner of magitech device, yet I dare not force it open. It may well be booby-trapped. I have heard of such devices. The Crystal Braves will possess the key. Let us split up and look for it. That will not be necessary. Oh. You have? Pray, do not take it personally, my friend. You are the victims of harsh economic conditions. If panda monks make it into Final Fantasy. Happily, you will not suffer for long. This poison will convey you swiftly into the bosom of Thal, where I hope to join you after the passing of many prosperous years. Oh man! Uh-oh. What's going on? You suffer the effect of concentrated poison. Uh-oh, this isn't good. Asuna! Asuna! Confound it, the mist stifles my healing! Farewell, friends! Oh, do try to relax. They tell me struggling only makes it worse. Cough! Leave me! Save yourselves! We cannot let them escape, Ari! Force the gate! Oh, okay. We're fighting the gate? Alright, can do. Can do. I'm all down for this. Let me run straight into the poison. Seriously, I have to try to assume to myself. Oh, benediction. That's not what I meant to cast. Of course I can't assume it. But I had to try, because I'm a white mage. This is a pretty weak poison for being a concentrated poison. Beast, the mist must be drawing them in. Oh god. Alphanote, you're so useless. What good are you? Nothing. Nothing. No good at all. Oh man, Yugiri made quick work of hers though. She's useful. Is he even doing anything? Oh, now he's casting. Oh, Alphanote, why? Can we save Raoban? How do we get Raoban out? But we must stop it at the source. Okay, we're looking for the source. We're not leaving Raoban. We're just looking for the source of the poison. The Braves have the key. Yeah, we know. Thanks, Raoban. Hey, training dummies. What are the chances it's down here? Not very good. Alright, let's keep going. Man, this poison can't even overcome my natural regen. Like, what kind of poison is this? Weak sauce. I Acerbic jam. Mmm, jam. I want some jam. Ah, no knockback. What's up with that? Oh, Alphanode, you're so useless. Why are you so useless? Rabon's a wimp, yeah. There's this weird tiny little bug on the base of my monitor that's white, so it stands out quite a lot against the black. And I don't know what the heck it is. I'm really disturbed by this. Man, I gotta run all the way back to the start. I cannot die, not yet. Oh, his vitality. Oh, Raubon's dying. Damn. Where's the source? Is it up here? No, that's the exit. Shit. How do I find? Oh, it's up here. Okay. Don't die on me, Raubon. Don't die on me. Actually, you know what? Let's just go after this. Oh god, it has so much health. Come on, Alphanode, be useful for once. Attacking all these at once. Bad idea. Thanks, Alphanode. Yeah, you get one of those off me. Seriously, Alphanode, tank. Do something. Do some DPS or something. There you go. I got you, Raubon. Don't you worry. Just hang in there. Oh, man. My ear is itchy. Oh, I think this bug can fly. Something just, like, dive-bombed my other monitor. I'm working on it, Fuzzy! I'm working on it! He's fine. He's got some health left. Alphanode. Oh god, you're gonna die, aren't you? Oh, shoot. No wonder this is taking so long. When did I lose? That takes care of the miss. Okay, his vitality's going up. I don't know where else we can go though. There wasn't anything else in here. Oh wait, which way do we come from? This way? Ah, here we go. These doors mustn't have been open. Close, but I got it. Indeed. Ooh, this looks like a job for Holy. Oh good, there we go. Lobotomize! Ah, how nice. Oh, I should probably heal myself. I'm like super low on health. Are you gonna drop a key? Oh, yeah, there's the key. I'm coming, Raoban! I'm coming! Don't you fear. I'm saving you. Oh, can I jump down through here? That's a bajillion times faster. Well, I mean, not a bajillion times faster than me jumping off the other side, but... Oh, I thought there was going to be voice acting. My thanks, Koth. Slowly, General. You are weak from your ordeal. Nevertheless, we must quit this place. I should have known. What are clever contrivances to the Warrior of Light? Well done, hero. Oh, ill bird. You need to die. You mean to struggle on, then? Very well. If you would stand in my way, I will cut you down like all the rest. Yeah? I want to see you try. Come, Scions, let's get this over with. Yeah, let me kick your ass. Come here. Come here, I want to holy the shit out of you guys. Nah, I probably should take out this conjurer first. I got this, guys. Ooh. Oh, somebody's healing me. It's okay, Raoban. We got this. I'll take care of you.
I have you now.
Who is healing me? I must be Geary. Legless Laurentius? Stop stabbing me in the back. Healing. Blah blah blah. Ari's getting aggressive. Damn straight. This guy betrayed... He betrayed his best friend. I just, like, can't support that. He's a dirty, dirty bastard. He deserves to die a horrible death. There we go. Done and done.
This changes nothing.
Did he have voice acting before?
It is over, Elbird. Lay down your arms and surrender yourself to justice.
Justice? Justice for what exactly? 'Twas not I who assassinated the Sultana, boy.
Pretty much did.
Ere we debate who is responsible for the assassination, I would ask whether an assassination took place at all.
What?
Oh, clever little shite. If you think you fight for justice, lass, you best wake up. The truth is, you fight for whoever bloody well tells you to. Can you not see you're being used by the Scions, the city-states, even the Crystal Braves? They none of them care a whit what you want, only what you can do for them. And how do I know this? Because I'm the same. A pawn to be used as my masters see fit. All I ever wanted was to liberate my homeland, and I ate dirt to make it happen. But what have I achieved after all these years in servitude? Nothing. Not a bloody thing. If we ourselves are not free, free to think and to act, how are we ever to reclaim our homeland? Know this. There is nothing I would not give to take back Alamigo. Nothing!
God damn, he's a crazy bastard. I'm blind!
You'll not get away.
That was hilarious.
No, Master Alphano. Now is not the time.
Aww.
A cripple and a fool. And still you came for me. I'm in your debt.
Ralbon, I'm gonna give you a big hug.
We're all of us fools of fate, General. But even fools have a part to play.
On your feet, Gladiator. This fight is not over.
Rest assured, I was not planning to die till I'd avenged the Sultana. Still, your words are welcome, lass.
Poor Ralbon.
Know this, Ilbert. There is nothing I would not give to see you pay for what you've done. My wealth, my arm, my life. Nothing.
I think he's already given his wealth and his arm. The only thing he has left to give is his life. So sad. They were best friends. They grew up together. They were like brothers. Now they just, like, hate each other. It's awful.
General,
all because Ilbert's a jerk.
Are you aware that Lord Lolorito has yet to announce the Sultana's death to the public?
Oh, his lack of arm. It's kind of a little bit flat. Shouldn't that be a little bit more rounded?
What? No. No, I was not aware of that, nor of anything else outside my cell. Tis passing strange, though. I assumed the bastard would make it known at the first opportunity and set about tearing down the Sultanate.
As did we all. Strange, or perhaps revealing. Now, I have no conclusive proof, nor do I wish to give you false hope, but I have reason to believe that Her Grace may yet live.
What? But how can that be?
Forgive me, friends, but it is not safe here. Let us continue this conversation without...
Oh my goodness, the expression on my face. So ridiculous. We already killed everybody in here. Seems safer, as safe here as it is anywhere else. Although I suppose they know where we are, they could come back with reinforcements. Alright, well that was fun. Dawari, what do you have to say? I think that's how you pronounce it. The general is safe. What news without? My lady, the guards have been subdued as per your command. We have since kept watch over the entrance. There's been no further activity. Then Ilbert and his minions have fled via some other egress. Scour the perimeters for signs of their passing. At once, my lady. Who's this dude? Dark stranger. General Alden, I presume, and the Scions of the Seventh Dawn? I suppose we are what's left of the Scions. Who are you? Identify yourself. Pray, do not be alarmed. My mistress is a friend, and I come bearing a message of goodwill. For your own safety, she bade me direct your steps to the Waking Sand. Know that Master Uriange awaits you there, along with others sympathetic to your cause. This is no ruse, I assure you. General Alden, if you will come with me, I have prepared a carriage that you may travel in comfort, safe from prying eyes. This seems suspect. Yugiri, go with him. We can't leave him alone. Oh, did he say for her to come with him? Alright. Speak with Alphinode. I don't trust this. I've spoken to Ariange via Linkper. He confirms this man's story. Raban's in safe hands. Let's make our own way to Wester Bay. Well, we don't know that Ariange is safe. He's been consorting with Asians. So I don't know. Shit could go down. Or else somebody's gonna be alive. Oh yeah! Trial accounts can't send friends requests anymore. It's been a beautiful thing. It's been a long time since I've been to the Waking Sands. Wandering daughter. Either something really good is going to happen or something really bad.
My dearest friends, praise be unto the Twelve for delivering you from the clutches of treachery.
Father!
Pippin, my son, and Master Papashan besides.
Forgive me, Father. I should have been at Her Grace's side.
Save your tears. The Sultana yet lives.
Does she for real?
You.
Who the heck is this?
It was I who arranged this gathering.
Who are you? I don't know who you are.
And judging by your perplexed expressions, it would seem introductions are in order. I am Dulala, head of the Order of Noldthol, and member of the Syndicate.
What you said about the Sultana, is it true? Is she alive?
Young lady, I understand you were with the Sultana when she drank from the poisoned goblet and collapsed. Would I be correct in assuming that you did not personally verify Her Grace's vital signs?
Why ask when 'tis plain you know the answer?
I love that he's pointing with his, like, not an arm.
Calm yourself, General, and let me finish. The truth is not as you imagine it. You are all victims of a most ingenious ruse. A ruse conceived to eliminate the threat posed by Telechi Adelechi.
Okay.
Tis my belief that Telechi plotted the Sultana's assassination alone, but that Lolorito caught wind of his plot and exploited it to his own ends. He sought to manipulate you into eliminating Telechi for him, and you duly obliged. At one fell swoop, he removed his two foremost rivals, all the while remaining above suspicion.
God strike me down for a fool. But the Sultana, how can it be that she lives?
She lives because Lolorito willed it. Her own lady-in-waiting is but one of his many little birds. By her sleight of hand, the poison was switched for a less deadly draught before it could reach her mistress's lips.
Some I knew it couldn't be her hand.
Of a
handmaiden.
Sufficient to induce a slumber like unto death.
What? Are we in Romeo and Juliet now?
Were I to guess, I would say her grace is being held somewhere, dreaming dreams of a brighter Uldar, even as we speak.
Aww.
Oh, Nanamo.
Oh, Robin. Robin.
I will never forgive Lolorito for his part in this.
He saved her. Well.
Though Lolorito's hands are far from clean, they did pluck her grace from the jaws of death. That must count for something. And though one may call the man's methods into question, it cannot be denied that he knows the value of stability, to the very gill, like as not. He craves power, tis true, but he has no desire to depose the Sultana. I had never taken sides in your feud with the monetarists, but it was not for want of concern for our nation's welfare. Indeed, 'twas out of the desire to see order restored that I furnished your Far Eastern friend with information.
Excuse me.
Arranged this gathering. I hope you are ready to work, General, for there is much work to be done. Our first priority must be to bring matters back into balance. Lest you forget Her Grace's words, the true wealth of Uldar lies in the health, happiness, and hopes of her people. As for the more worldly kind of wealth, I am content to let Lolorito help himself to whatever Telechi Adelechi left behind. You, meanwhile, must do that which you alone can do. Rescue Her Grace, and take your place at her side once more, for her sake, and that of our nation.
Oh, Nanamo's gonna be so sad that he lost his arm. Give me some XP. I had not counted on the prioress Dulala herself appearing. In my defense, my suspicions regarding the Sultana proved more prescient. Much remains to be done, but in rescuing Rauban, we have taken the vital first steps towards resolving the matter in Ulda. We couldn't have done it without you, Ari. Thank you. I don't even know what to take. Maybe a ring of casting would be more helpful. Jailbreak! Yeah! Elfinode is distracted by a call on his Licked Pearl. To siege or not to siege? Tataru? Yes, General Rabon is now in safe hands. What? Another assault? Very well. We shall return at once. Pray notify the Count of our coming. Oh, back to Ishgard. It would seem we face another crisis. The Dravanians are preparing to resume their siege of the Holy See. Though I'm loath to abandon the Sultana to her face, we lack the necessary evidence to act upon Dvalala's claims. That being the case, I propose we leave Marshal Terrapin and the others to investigate, and return with all haste to Ishgard. Alright, I guess that's what we're doing. Alright. To Ishgard! Last vigil. There seem to be more quests available. Mum's the word. This House Durandar knight needs an adventurer who can keep a secret. Why is he outside of House Fortomp? You keep clicking off your mount after teleporting. Oh, can you teleport while you're on your mount now? I think that seems vaguely familiar. Excuse me. You're not from around here, are you? I know this is sudden, but I have a favor to ask. I'm looking for someone to deliver a gift to a friend in Falcon's Nest. What? Well, it's a surprise, so I can't really say. I just need you to deliver it, that's all. You can pick it up from the knights at the brush at the Forgotten Knight. You'll know him when you see him. I'm sure he'll recognize you as well. Okay. You're sketchy. Are we going to advance this, like, this party plot? An unwanted delivery. Torsifers looks sick with worry. I look worried? Nonsense. Why would I have anything to be worried about? Okay, I suppose there's no harm in telling you. Lord Amenelane requests I deliver a missive to Lady Lynette at the Rose House. I remember him specifically mentioning that failure would not be tolerated. It is a simple task, yet the thought of something going awry has my stomach in knots. I am loath to thrust my duties upon another, but would you be willing to deliver this missive? I cannot afford to take chances. Surely a woman of your talents can see the deed done without fail. Please, you are my only hope. Yeah, you big wimp. I'll do stuff for you. Don't worry. Tataru! Ah, there you are. Sorry for cutting your reunion with General Rauban short. I wouldn't have bothered you, but the city's awash with rumors of another Dravanian attack, and Lord Harshafond was desperate to get a hold of you. Speaking of whom, he and the others are waiting inside, so you'd best head in. Alright, let me in the house. My friend, thank you for answering our call with such alacrity. Alacrity? I'm sure you are now aware the Dravanians are much once more gathering for war. You like that soft little voice? Mr. Savannah, Master Levayer, I must apologize for this abrupt summons, but we thought it best to have Mr. Sitaru contact you by the most direct means available. When the observatorium's bells toll, 'tis a warning that cannot be ignored. The Holy See has ordered that we make ready for battle. Oh yeah, he's supposed to have a manlier voice. In case you haven't heard, a band of trappers returning from the west claim to have seen a cloud of dragons big enough to dim the midday sun. Nidhogg's minions gathered once more for war. But I would not have you take up arms in another of our conflicts. When first you came to Ishgard, I offered you my protection. If I cannot ensure your safety here, I cannot well accept your aid, much less ask for it. Scions of the Seventh Dawn, you are faced with a choice. To remain in a besieged Ishgard, or to seek sanctuary elsewhere. I would not presume to influence your decision, but I must ask that you make it swiftly, lest our enemies force your hand. Ooh, give me some more XP. Yeah. Although we flee to the ends of the world, 'twould seem that no place in this troubled age is free of strife. Words. Once more the hordes descend upon Ishgard, and once more her weary defenders must take up spear and bow. The Count would have us seek shelter from this storm, but I, for one, grow tired of running. If we are to shine in the light of dawn, we must do so in sight of our fellow man, not hunkered in a hole. What say you, Ari? I would stay and fight. Then fight we shall. Let it never be said that we abandon our allies in their hour of need. Alright, next quest. I wonder what would happen if I said, let's go hide. Alphanode is deliberating how best to proceed. Alphanode's way. The choice we make this day may have grave implications for our order. It is only right that Tataru should have a say. Come, let us all meet outside and discuss the path that lies before us. Alright, guess we're going outside. Oh. Alphanode.
Ishgard cannot well endure another assault. Even should her knights succeed in turning back the Horde, the casualties will be catastrophic.
But what other choice do we have? It's not like we can talk it over with them. Dragons and men aren't exactly on speaking terms.
With certain notable exceptions.
Oh, me and Midgardsmer?
You don't mean Iceheart?
Oh. Yeah, I guess she talks to them too.
When last you spoke with her, she lamented her crimes, did she not? Then there remains a sliver of hope. If we can persuade Iceheart to act as our intermediary, we may yet be able to convince Nidhogg to abandon his bloody course.
If there is to be a meeting, I would
accompany. Who the heck are you?
Estinian.
Oh. Mr. Dragoon.
Even with your intermediary, Nidhogg's blood rage may render him deaf to reason. However, the mere attempt may afford our forces precious time to prepare. Of course, you might also consider a more direct approach to ending this conflict. With the power of the Eye at my disposal, and the vaunted strength of the Warrior of Light, we could conceivably slay the beast outright.
If we are to risk a face-to-face meeting with the Dread Worm, I for one would feel safer in the company of the Azure Dragoon. However, I should only turn to your lance if my words failed to find their mark. Is that clear?
Perfectly. I should assume that Isar enjoys similar diplomatic protection until instructed otherwise. A word of advice. Think carefully before divulging the particulars of this plan to Sir Emeric. 'Twould not do to have the Lord Commander accused of consulting with heretics.
I thought he was saying he was untrustworthy, but no, we just don't want to get him in trouble. Fair enough.
Indeed. I thank you for your counsel, Estinian. We shall be honored to have you with us.
I am glad to be of service.
Man, I've been sitting on my desk a long time. We have chosen a difficult road. Yet even should we succeed in winning Iceheart to our cause, our plans for parley will swiftly come to naught should the Holy See decide to strike first against the Horde. We must petition the Lord Commander's aid ere we set forth. I only hope that Ser Imeric will be willing to muzzle Ishgard's forces on the strength of our vague assurances. Tataru, I would ask that you remain at Fortom's manor and inform the Count of our decision. Tell him that the Scions of the Seventh Dawn mean to do all in their power to ensure that Ishgard and her people survive. Yes, sir! Alright. What am I doing now? Where is Rose House? Oh, Cloud Top. Okay. Oh, I have to go to the Forgotten Knight. Oh, God. Oh, lag. You would speak with the Lord Commander. Pray, make it quick. I would love to speak to the Lord Commander. Oh, Ser Imeric, you're my favorite.
I want the defenses of the Outer Ward rechecked. See to it that the ballistas are in good repair and supplied with enough ammunition for a prolonged siege.
At once, my lord.
Ah, 'twould seem I have visitors. And unlike those messing beyond our walls, these ones are welcome.
Yay!
Pray forgive us for interrupting you in the midst of your preparations, Ser Imeric. But our suit concerns the impending assault. To speak plain, we believe there is a chance the invasion might be halted before it even begins. I can divulge little more at this time, but I must nevertheless request that you advise the Holy See to refrain from launching any preemptive sorties whilst we seek to put our plans in motion.
I don't understand. The Azure Dragoon was like, hey, don't tell Ser Imeric about what we talked about. What's the first thing we do? Go talk to Ser Imeric. I don't understand. This is super confusing. I think that we're just like not telling him what we're doing. We're just telling him not to attack, but it just still seems silly. It's like, hey, psst, don't tell Ser Imeric. Oh, let's just go talk to him right now.
I will gladly lend my support to any endeavor that could spare the blood of my countrymen, but I would know more of the cause you would have me champion. Will you not share aught of this mysterious undertaking?
Although, I guess they pronounce it Imeric more than Imeric. Apparently I pronounce the Y too much. Imeric?
Know that I have offered my lance to aid in this endeavor. I cannot claim that its success is assured. But our actions should serve to delay Nidhogg's advance at the very least. Which is more than can be said for the ill-conceived counterattack advocated by the Sea's more vocal crusaders. They offer glorious death, but little hope of victory.
Aye, their proposal does not inspire confidence. Our resources should rightly be spent shoring up the city's defenses.